Good evening, everybody. Good Friday evening. Hello. Welcome to Talking with Heathens. I am Sid. This is my buddy right there, Papa. And Luna. This is Luna Ravenwolf.
Luna.
I'm trying to get the finger pointing right here.
Yeah.
I'll never get it right the first time, I don't think. Nope. Welcome to the show, everybody who is watching here on Stream TV. Our Heathen Nation television channel. Welcome to you guys. Welcome everybody who's watching it on YouTube and Facebook as well. How are you two doing?
Practically perfect as always. And you?
I am wonderful.
You're wonderful?
Wonderful.
I'm good. I'd say I'm good. It's been a crazy week. I'm not really crazy week, but just one of those weeks, like, you know, you're trying to get into the dentist and this and that. It's just been one of those weeks. When do you see the dentist? It's been a busy week, but a good week. I can't really complain for me over here. Weather's been nice, cloudy, but it's not snowing, so I'll take that as a win.
So basically, you did things you didn't want to do this week.
Well, that's everything. I don't want to do anything. I just want to sit around and just play video games. Be real nerdy.
You sound like a teenager.
And a wife beater on with Cheeto handprints all over my chest. That's my ambition.
I think you need to recalibrate.
What's up, Papa?
I would go stir crazy. I would have to get out. You know, so.
Yeah, I couldn't do that in reality. I hate the winter months. I'm ready to go to take a walk. I'm ready to take a walk down Wabash River and see what it's like. But it's just been kind of crappy weather. It's either been raining or it's been snowing or it's just... You're not going to want to go by yourself. I mean, your kids are going to want to go with you. And it's just been too chilly, I think, here to take about
it. It's been, a busy time of year for everybody. We turn that first of the year and everybody shifts gears into getting things done and getting those doctor's appointments in and kids get back to school.
I'm not looking forward to it. Nobody likes the dentist. If you do, then you're already on medication for this. Whatever problem I'm going through, you've already got medicated for it.
You're a weirdo.
Yeah, you're a weirdo.
Yeah.
I have bad anxieties when it comes to it. So that due sedation, it's just a whole big spiel. I had to go get consulted about that.
What you can do before you go to the dentist?
What can I do? Meditate? Yeah. If I meditate on it, I'm talking myself out of it. If I'm meditating when I'm telling myself all the reasons why I should stay home.
I do that sometimes where I'm like, I have something I want to do but necessarily don't want to do, and I try to like convince myself not to do it.
Papa's had a busy week too, haven't you, buddy? You've been like just crafting away. Supposed to be taking time off, and then here you go, just crafting away on days that you're supposed to be relaxing.
Yeah, I was going to try to finish out in a little bit of holiday time off, but I couldn't do it. There's too much in the mind that was spinning and wanting to be created, and it got too difficult to deny that.
If you guys are watching here on stream, Papa, tell everybody where they can find your website. Tell everybody exactly what we're sitting here chatting personally, like, you know, because we're friends. But there's people out here potentially watching this that doesn't know what exactly you do. So kind of describe to everybody real briefly what's your trade, so to speak.
First and foremost, if you're looking for the website and goods, I'm a craftsman. Make drums and rattles and meditation tools, spiritual tools, and work in runic divination. Lots of different wares that have to do with spirituality, and it's all nature-based. Getting back to nature, crafting with nature, being a part of that great circle and cycle. Fjallbetir.com is where you can find those things.
Oh.
Right up there on the banner behind me.
Plug it, baby, plug it.
It's one of the workshops that I use in my crafting, and so you'll see some of those things featured here behind me too.
Yeah, because go on, Leah.
I have a question. What does that mean?
Fjallvetir?
Yes.
Well, it's made up of two words. Vetir is spirit. So you heard the land vetir, the land spirit. Húsvetir, hús spirit, house spirit. Fjall and fjell are mountain, so it's mountain spirit. I live up here in the Blue Ridge Mountains of Appalachia, and millions and millions and millions of years of history and spirit here has resided and still does, that I get to take advantage of in my practice and my craft and being surrounded by it.
Very fortunate too. That's got to be super cool. Not everybody has opportunities like it to kind of live out your... You're getting to live your lifestyle out authentically. That's really cool. You know, most people have to put on the, I got to go to work to the 9-to-5 clothes and then come back home and get your normal, regular, comfortable clothes.
But
we're fortunate that we're not having to do that. I hated that.
So I don't want anyone to think that you can't do it. It's not easy. But if you want to do it, you can. You can get out of that grind. You can get out of the rat race or the hamster wheel, whatever you want to call it. Start to create your own world.
Get out of the mundane bullshit that's called life.
Preach it.
Meditate on that.
Meditate on that for a minute. Chew on that for a second. We've been sitting there throwing out little hints about our topic tonight, and we're talking. It's an interesting subject because this is the one where I have a bit of a disadvantage talking about. I can't really give any like sound good advice about waves or the reasons why. I can give you reasons why you meditate, but I can't give you like ways that I do it that'll be like helpful to anybody. Just I'm not good at it. I'm sure there's probably more than just me out there who struggles with, you know, doing your traditional way of meditating. That's just, I can't.
You can.
No, I can't.
Yes, you can.
I can do guided meditations.
Yes, those are nice.
But sitting and trying to sit and do like a session of meditating, like I'm going to sit for 10 minutes to say, I'm going to meditate for these next 10 minutes. That 10 minutes feels like an hour.
Well, you're probably fighting your thoughts.
Yeah, that's what a lot of it is. Yeah.
It is one of the most common things that I get when people want to talk about spirituality, spirit path, and shamanism, is that meditation is such a core in so many things when you're venturing into that path that people feel like they can't do it. They can't sit still or devote or get benefit out of that time doing it. But I think it's because through pop culture and society, when we think meditation, we automatically now think that guru or that Indian guy in his garb and legs folded and arms out and just at zen and peace and nirvana up on a mountain with the sunshine behind him. But there are so many different ways to meditate. There really are. Most of you probably do it without realizing it.
That would probably be my case. Well, it's not
allowing yourself time to focus on your thoughts and your spirit, that's meditation.
To me, it's hyper-focusing on something, whether it be good or bad or evil or wicked, pure and loving. It's whatever you're giving attention to the most, you're meditating on it. I mean, my husband and I were talking about that today. He says, meditation is balance. And I'm like, no, that's what you find after you meditate is balance. But meditation is, you know, thinking on one thing over and over again many times. And, you know, you hear of premeditation murder. You know, like, it's not always about balance, right? It's not always about positivity. Like, some people premeditate things, and I'm only using that as an example. But it's like you're looking inwards of what your heart desires, and you're wanting to bring that about into a plan. And some people use it for good, and some people use it for evil. So,
To focus on a thing, like to focus on your thoughts or a plan or a goal, or you can meditate to not focus on anything at all and clear your mind completely. That's why a lot of people meditate for relaxation. People will meditate before going into another spiritual practice to sort of clear their mind, erase all that, and come to peace.
So what is the definition of meditation?
It is a focused time spent on your thoughts, whether it be for focus on your thoughts or meditation for relaxation. That's a lot of the verbatim, the definition that you'll get for meditation.
Well, we use meditation to find wisdom and knowledge.
Or to relax. It's like a lot of the New Age spirituality, a lot about just relaxing. Just sitting around, like, just sitting around relaxing. New Age ones, New Age folks. That's what they do to relax a lot.
I used to be New Age.
To hear yourself think.
Yeah, but the thing of it is that we tend to not allow thoughts to pass by. When we go into meditation, let's say I'm Sid. I'm going into meditation. Fucking hate this, right? Like, I don't want to do this because I know, like, I'm not going to get there. But then if he takes time to breathe and he goes into his belly, you have to remember there are no thoughts in your belly. I always feel that. Like,
well, isn't a lot of meditation also training your muscles and your breathing and stuff like that also as well to go into a proper meditative state?
And when you focus on your breathing,
it depends on the intention of your meditation.
probably a lot of my reason too, though, too, is that I don't feel like I get anything out of it. Because probably a lot of reasons, because I'm not doing it right. To be fair, meditation's never been one of my go-to things, I guess. But I do it different. We all do it in different ways, I reckon.
Well, when I meditate, and those thoughts are coming through, I always thank those thoughts. I give them some love and some recognition, and then I let them go. Then the next thought comes. I do the same thing, and then I let them go until I start receiving messages that I need to hear. It's a very peaceful experience.
So, where did, maybe Papa, you might know this, where did the whole idea of meditating originate from?
I don't think as an idea it originated in any one specific place. It's just sort of a thing that calls to humanity to sit. I think we've done it throughout the existence of humanity, to sit alone with our thoughts and focus on our thoughts for a little while. It's always been a thing, but I think it got popular through the gurus.
I didn't know, I wasn't for sure if it was a culture, a certain culture that kind of, like Buddhism. Does Buddhism have anything to do with a lot to do with meditating?
Yeah, I think the Asian spiritual cultures have definitely popularized it. People see those monks and those gurus, and they look very peaceful, and they think it looks like they've got it all figured out. And so that's very attractive, and people want to buy into that. They want to try it too and do it if it's...
Well, they get to that point, though, then it's even possible to be that blissful. Yeah, that takes a lot of practice, really, to be fair, right? I mean, you got to spend a lot of time learning and practicing what works for you as far as, like, shutting some of the noise in your head down, right?
Or you get itchy. You start to itch. And you learn to not scratch that itch. Yeah. You learn to pay attention. So during meditation, when you start getting itchy, you know, because you're in a state of resistance for a minute when you start, and then all of a sudden your body just starts tingling, or you get a little itching sensation. So what I do is I, just the same with my thoughts, I give it attention. I know you are there. Okay, bye. Thank you. You know, does that part of my body need attention? Does it not? And then I move on. It's really hard to get there, honestly, because I've had a few like itches where I'm like, oh my God, like I need to scratch this really bad. But you learn to find your comfort and to get in the zone. And for some people, it takes a few years to get there, you know. But that's, you know, I want to say that I'm North Pagan, but I'm not sure, but I believe that in North Paganism, we use meditation as a way to connect with the spirit world, to find the wisdom within the gods and to bring it home to us. Sitting in silence and listening to our heart and it's almost like doing a reading, you know, when you do readings and stuff, or oracle cards or rune readings. You're seeing what it is that's going to come up for your day or the next day, and you meditate on that, and there's some wisdom there for you, and you meditate on those things.
I tried to meditate one time out in the state park once. That actually was a one of the few successful ones that I actually did, where I just kind of went out in the middle of nowhere, just sat on a log and just kind of closed my eyes and tried to see if I can stop making my mind so busy, and I can see if I can pay attention to some of the like birds chirping or the leaves blowing. And I got to that state where everything else was closed off, when I was hearing all the, what we would, every day we walk good and never recognize, but all the background noise of the birds chirping or rustling around in the leaves, animals doing their thing. I was like super tuned into it. It was pretty cool, actually. One of the few times.
You can take that beyond as well. You can go into the universe. You can go into like the earth moving and the sound of the universe and everything. Like, it's really cool.
Well, that's my happy place.
There was something else that I was going to mention. A lot of times for a lot of people, when they find they're having trouble meditating or feel like they can't do it, environment plays a very big part. Some of them can't be helped. You've got kids, and kids are noisy. Mm-hmm. And you're trying to meditate, you've got your eyes closed, you're finding peace, and then you hear glass break, you kind of snap out of it. It doesn't. So your atmosphere, your environment are very important in getting fulfillment out of meditation.
And you don't always have to, you don't have to sit still, do you? You can dance, you can sing.
Well, that's what I'm going to get to next, Pop. Let me ask you. What are some of the ways that you meditate? What are some of the practices that you do it?
Well, a lot of people think that you have to sit in silence, but that's not true. One of the most popular ways to meditate is to chant during meditation. I think in some of the Eastern cultures, they call it mantra, to chant. Some of the ways that I personally meditate, other than sitting alone in a quiet space outside, focused on my thoughts or focused on nothing at all, is in the medicine walk. I walk while meditating. I have my eyes open and my ears open, and my focus is on my surroundings, but it's in a way that's peaceful enough that I'm able to go into and focus on my thoughts along with those in a harmony.
Like that word you guys said, hypersensitive to what's going on around you.
A lot of people find meditation through crafting. I do that sometimes. I'll zone out and I'll be focused on that piece and in that moment with that piece and my thoughts that revolve around it and its creation. And I feel that's also meditation.
It brings your crafting to life, gives it meaning.
What about you, Luna?
Me? Yeah. What was the question?
What are some of the ways that you meditate?
I like to dance.
You like to dance and meditate?
Yes, I do. I like to dance.
Traditional ways. You guys kind of like made these two you guys' own to fit your own little way of doing things, haven't you?
Yeah. Because it's hard for me, just like you said, to sit there and be quiet. It's very hard for me. I need to be moving, doing something. I need it to have purpose. So whatever purpose that is, that's how I dance.
You're very much not alone in that. A lot of tribal cultures and communities, and the spiritual people there, and medicine people, and men and women, use dance to access that altered state of consciousness, and to kind of send you into another place. Repetitive dance, repetitive movements, doing things over and over and over in sequence. It's a way to access.
Within the dance, we find our voice. So usually while I'm dancing, I have thoughts and words, maybe chants, that hit my heart and I need to speak them out loud. So I do that. And there's one chant that I like to say, I don't know who it's by, but I wrote it down. And I do this during the full moon, and it's And words are so powerful. They're amazing. But I say, by the light of the moon, my path becomes clear. By the light of the moon, my heart opens wide. By the light of the moon, my way becomes simple. And by the light of the moon, I find my way home. And in that is sentimentality. And that in itself brings me close to nature, that brings me close to the gods and the goddesses. And that makes me dance wonderfully.
You are a dance around the fire trip person, aren't you?
Yes, I am.
You can see that screaming and yelling. Yeah. That's cool, though. I mean, what's cool about it, from what just hearing what you guys do, it's a mixed bag really, for what you guys, for how you guys meditate. I mean, it's not really your traditional way. You don't hear too many people, at least I haven't, that run around and dance and able to meditate. Putting those two together, it doesn't seem like it would work, but apparently it does, right?
When
works for you.
To music, we are meditating. We are making that music our own.
We'll get to that second part of the show, because I want to talk about the second part of the show. About different, if people are struggling out there and doing their traditional way of meditating, what are other forms of meditating? Like Papa was saying earlier, at the beginning of the show, we probably do it more than what we think we do. And that's just during the beginning of the show when Papa said that, I've already thought about one or two things in my head. But, oh, wait a second.
Yeah.
Maybe I am meditating and just doesn't realize it. I'm just not doing it the traditional way.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's interesting. But it's cool to see how you guys made it work for you guys yourself. How you got it. Now, how often do you two recommend people meditating for? Or how often during like a week's period of time, or is it one of those things you just know it, you feel it, and hey, I'm gonna go sit and meditate.
At least
you're
like
gonna practice every day as a routine, I guess.
At least once a month.
I would say it's entirely up to the individual. If you feel yourself that you're forcing it into time or space that doesn't allow for you to develop that peace, then it's all for naught. It's a waste of time because you're sitting there stressed knowing I've only got 10 minutes and I've got to go back and do this. So you're going to waste that 10 minutes. You're going to be filled with worry the whole time, anxiety. You're not going to get the peace that you seek out of it. When you can do it, when it's comfortable for you, and as often as possible. When we get to the second part of the show, I'll talk about that a little bit more, but it's something that we aren't getting enough in our day-to-day lives.
That being said, we're going to take a quick break. You guys are watching Talking with Heathens, hanging out with myself, Sid, Papa, and Luna. We're talking about tonight's topic, meditating. And so we're going to take a quick video break, and we'll be right back, guys. So stick where you're at. Matter of fact, go grab a soda, grab some chips, and then come back.
Hey, this is Josie Scott, the original OG lead singer of Saliva, and you are watching Inner Demon Media. Release your inner demons. We all have demons. We just don't try to hide them.
Push myself around. so cynical.
Welcome back, everybody, to Talking with Heathens. That was our friends Carbon Stone and Anoxia. Husband and wife, little team up there with their song Pins and Needles. If you guys have not followed them on Facebook or checked out their YouTube channels, highly suggest to go check them out. Carbon Stone, you can find on Facebook, just type in Carbon Stone and Anoxia as well. So in the search bar, type in Anoxia. We'll give them a follow, like, share, get connected with the bands, because they're really good bands, good friends of ours with Inner Demon Media.
They're awesome people.
Yeah, they're good folk. They really are. You ask them to do anything for you, they just about jump right at it for you to do it. So it's really
very
nice
down to
build
earth.
These connections with the community outside of just the pagan community, but with the music community as well.
That video was a little bit of meditation too.
Was it?
Yeah, because in meditation we're always, well, I am at least, but most people are fighting themselves, fighting the voices and the things that are in their head, and they're focusing on these parts of them that they do not like about themselves, their shadow selves.
Well, Papa, do you struggle with, is there steps, a process you go through when you meditate to shut down the mind to be able to focus on what you're meditating about?
Oh, yeah, I like to start with breathing. Breathing exercises get inside your body before you get inside your mind. Get that control set and that rhythm and that pattern set for your breath. And then from there, it's a lot easier to focus on your mind and your thought.
I think it's important before you do that to ground yourself.
Yeah.
Yeah. So your coming back is easy. Because sometimes we get lost in that realm, you know, of where we're going, and we forget about reality.
So you ground yourself first. We can safely say ground yourself first. Mm-hmm. Then get your breathing technique down to a pattern. Then what happens after that? What's the process after you get your breathing down? Does it depend on what you're wanting to meditate on, or is it just something you just want to? You can just sit down. It's like, all right, I want to meditate, but there's nothing in general that I want to meditate about. Well, is there steps that you go through that might help people that are viewing this?
What I like to do if I'm trying to just clear my head, get into a place of peace and relax and enjoy it. Behind my eyelids, I just picture black and then a single white speck in the middle of that black, like a star in the sky, but it's the only star out there. And then I let my focus go on that, and then I feel myself going closer and closer and closer to that. And in that focus, blocking everything else out, it brings on that, okay, now I'm out here, now I'm in this open, dark space that, and I don't mean dark in a bad way, but dark in as in it's peaceful and you're free to explore your thoughts.
You have room to create.
Right.
So as you're going more and more towards this light, what is at the end of, what's at the end destination?
Just to get out there to a point that I'm able to focus on my thoughts, and that other things aren't creeping in, or
so that's your chi area. When you get to that white light, that's like your chi area, right?
I don't always go to it. I get about halfway there, and then that's the good spot. And then when I'm ready to come back, I move forward again to the white light. And then as I come out of the white light, I'm back out of the meditation here in the world.
Nice.
I have a sanctuary that I go to.
You have a little safe place?
A little safe place. So in my mind, I have a lot of dream meditation out of body experiences. So what I like to do is I am in a, how do I explain it? Lots of grass, lots of green grass. I'm on a cliff looking down into the water, kind of like Lord of the Rings. Like, so when you're looking across, there's a cliff and there's waterfalls coming. On top of that waterfall is a little cave, and that is where my sweet spot is. And I am a person, but as soon as I jump, I become a raven. And I fly into my cave, and I hang out, chill by the fire, do some magic, and then downstairs, I walk downstairs, a little windy staircase, and that's where the gods are. I have a little, I guess, a bath, so to speak, where, I'm sorry if this is inappropriate, but I take off all of my clothing and get into this bath and hang out with the gods. When I'm all done, I get up, they put a purple robe on me, and I go back to my chair and sit and meditate on what they have said to me, and then I fly back to my cliff, become human, and come back to the earthly realm.
What's the process like for you to get from starting your meditation to getting to that point that you just described?
It takes just a few moments, and it's actually gut-wrenching because I'm afraid of heights. So becoming that raven and being able to trust the wind and the elements that are around me, it takes a lot. Like I said, it takes practice to not, because there are times where I've turned into a raven and I've lost faith and I have fallen. And I, you know that, have you ever had dreams where you're falling and you have that, you know?
Wake up out of the dream going, oh.
Yes.
I'm going to fall, thank goodness.
I don't think that you lost faith. I think you lost trust in yourself and that your wings would work.
Yes. I believe that.
So it's really quick for you to sit down and go right into that meditative state of being by the waterfalls. There's no decompressing moments where you're clearing your headspace to get to that point?
Well, it's because during my travels in life, with cross-country trips and such, I have come in contact with such a place, so it's easier for me to relate to and picture in my mind's eye that that is where I'm going.
And I do think it's something that the more you practice, the quicker you can go into it, the easier it is to find yourself in a meditative state.
I truly believe that, yeah, because it definitely takes training your mind to do what you want to do and not what your mind's telling you to do. And that can be a task. When we require people like myself to actually sit down and dedicate myself to keep doing it until I get to that point where I'm doing it right, at least. But heck, like I said, like you was talking about earlier, about we're doing it without even knowing we're doing it. I just thought about a scenario, me getting up. I get up super early in the morning because that's my quiet time. I don't know how I let it just like pass by my head, not thinking about it. But that's my quiet time from like 3 o'clock till 6-ish when the boys get up. That's completely quiet for me. And I do a lot of just sitting around. I don't even do anything. I just have a sip of my coffee and just sit with myself. So I guess that 3-hour span there in between, give or take, that's every day, that's my meditation time, I guess. If you look at it that way, it's not your traditional sitting with your legs crossed, you know, but it's just me sitting there decompressing, letting everything just kind of go, and then kind of going with the mentality of, okay, what do I got to do today? What am I going to do today as far as am I going to, as just a daily spiritual walk, you know, just that time of the day for me is my sweet spot, I guess.
Where you're setting your stage.
Yeah.
And not to get off topic or subject for the evening, but not only is that meditation, but if it's something that you do that way each and every day, that's also considered ritual.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. It's your ritual.
I can't believe I let it pass right through my head, not even thinking about that. I do that every single day. 3 a.m. to about 6 when the boys get up. Give or take sometimes. Maybe not every day I do it. Maybe I'm exaggerating, but I do that a lot. Just sit there and just, I just in complete silence, just with a night light on, and that's it. Pretty much darkness. Sipping on coffee, just kind of gathering my thoughts, decompressing, plus charting out my day, like you said, Luna, just kind of focus. It's everything's quiet, so I can really focus on what I want to do that day. So I guess that is my meditation time. I take it all back, guys. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I get a lot of people that will come and want to get into meditation. They don't know why, but they feel like it should be a part of their path, a part of their practice, something that they want to explore for their spirituality. And they don't know why, so I ask them, when is the last time you were alone with your thoughts? And when is the last time you found yourself saying, I can't even hear myself think? Because we live that now. It's how we live. There's something constantly either in your face or in your ear that's noise. The more we've progressed, the more we're living in cities and communities and suburbs, and there's fire trucks and there's trash trucks and there's construction work and there's horns honking and there's planes overhead.
We live a fast lifestyle.
You work in a building that has music playing the entire time that you particularly don't like. People talking to you all day long. When is the last time you really got to be alone with your thoughts, focus on your thoughts without all this distraction and noise?
It's more of, when have you become mindful of being alone in your thoughts? Because I think that we can be alone in our thoughts even though there's those distractions and noises. Yeah,
we've had to condition ourselves to zone those things out.
Yeah. And that can be hard.
We work through them.
Because you're always around, like Papa said, everything he just mentioned there, you deal with on an everyday basis. Life is really fast. And people just struggle now just to keep up. I mean, everything is about speed, speed, speed. And when it comes to meditating, that's a total polar opposite of what you're doing in everyday life. Everything in reality, life, work-wise, just living is fast. Mm-hmm. And then here's meditation saying, no, we'll put that in reverse. I'm going to go at this a little bit slower. And that takes some training to condition yourself to transition from living a fast lifestyle.
Meditation is Earth time. It's not society's time. It's Earth time. It's the universe. The universe's time. When we're tapping into energy and we're calling to the spirits or whatever, creating this energy around us to get us in a trance-like state, it's really easy. I lost my train of thought because I started meditating. Hold on. You get yourself into this trance-like state and you're able to block out all the things around you. It's actually really, really easy for me because I'm often in my own little world anyway. But like society, like you had said, you're going at a really fast pace. You never have like time to like sit and be by yourself. But you have to learn to meditate while you're on that bus, while you're on the train or the tram or the L or whatever it is that you're on. Like that time where you're just sitting there and you're not really connecting with anyone, you can take that time to connect with your spirit or connect with whatever it is that you believe in and have that walk by your side throughout the day. I'm sorry,
Definitely takes training and practicing at doing it. And probably the best way of doing that, just keep doing it frequently, right?
Yeah.
There are a lot of tools to aid in meditation.
Yeah, talk a little bit about that. I mean, you're like a specialist at that.
No, it's just, it's a lot of things that people have picked up through practice over the years that find that if you have a single thing to focus on, it makes it easier to block all the other things out as far as distraction. In modern times, a lot of people will turn to music or a song to block out the neighbor's noise, the lawnmower on the other side of the street, the cars going by. It's hard to block all of those things out, but if you can put some headphones on or earbuds and listen to music, you can block all those things out, then easier go in meditation with only that one thing to worry about. In a more traditional sense, things like singing bowls. I'm sure that you guys have seen those things. The sound that it makes. Nature sounds are another great meditation tool. Incense, to focus on that smell, is a great meditation tool. Chanting,
yeah, the juniper. I like to use the juniper, burning juniper to clear my space. And for protection, to keep those things that are trying to distract me from my meditation. And also brings medicinal healing and things like that too. So that's very helpful to bring herbs, bring the earth into your meditation space to get close.
And another great tool, Sid, you had mentioned this one earlier that you're slightly particular to and that you felt has maybe helped you a little bit more, is the guided meditation.
Yeah.
And when you have someone there that's helping and walking through in various ways, whether it be playing an instrument or speaking your journey.
Speaking your journey to you makes it, for some reason, makes it, I'm able to connect with it more than me trying to sit here and create this labyrinth thing that I.
Yeah.
It's just easier for me, I guess, the times that I've done it, having somebody kind of walk me through and I'm visioning what they're, my own version of what they're telling me that I'm seeing.
It's hypnotic.
Yeah.
It's Michael cool. Feely. It's pretty cool.
I commend anybody that's able to spend the time and really focus on meditating, because not everybody can do it. I mean, I'm a perfect example. I can't do it. I guess I do it, but not in your way that I don't. I guess, damn, I can't say that, because now I've done said earlier that I do it every damn morning, and I do.
Yeah.
I just keep thinking traditional, sitting there with your legs crossed. That tells you how ignorant I am about meditating.
Well, that's the popular image of it. That's the famous image of it. But it's just the same as anything else. We think to make music, we have to be in a packed arena on a stage with pyrotechnics, but people make music every day at various levels, and some of it speaks more to the heart in those raw and primitive forms than when all of the technology is added and all of the venue and the lights and the smoke and the pyrotechnics.
So it's just hobbies as well. If you have like certain hobbies you like doing, I guess that could be meditation as well, or at least a tool from getting in that sort of meditative purpose, like wood burning. You start off with a design and we're burning this to get that end result. So we're like super focused on what we're doing. But through that process, you got music playing in the background, helping you stay in that magical mood. You was doing it the other day, and I thought it was cool listening to you tell me, oh, this song's on, and here she's just wood burning away, listening to the radio station.
Yeah.
And just having a good old time doing it.
It was a beautiful experience, actually, because it was everything. It felt like everything that you were playing, you were doing it on purpose.
Nope, it's a playlist. Just playing.
Yeah, it was wonderful, and it really helped. It really helped me. I was focusing on the music and putting that into my work. And I think, when we interviewed Josie Scott, and you were talking about how he had helped change your life so much, that's because you were meditating, bro.
Oh yeah.
On that song. Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
On his music. I just keep thinking of like the whole ignorant side of me, the image of sitting with your legs crossed doing this and
hogwash.
And what Papa said is we do it and don't even realize it. It made me stop and actually I was sitting there pondering of all the different ways that I have been meditating. Now I feel like a hypocrite saying that I'm not good at it because I am really good at it.
Yeah.
It's just my way of doing it. Finding those opportunities to be able to do meditation.
In this moment, we're thinking, we're being mindful of what we're saying. We're listening and hearing each other and taking it to heart. That's meditation.
I definitely like to meditate before and during my work, my practice, and crafting. I think the most popular way that it's ever been put is that in cooking, your energy goes into your cooking. And you can tell if somebody's in a bad mood or pissed off when they've cooked food.
We've talked about this before.
And you can tell when they felt full of love when they cooked food. And the same energy carries over in crafting and producing pieces. Your energy is imbued in that thing that you're being hands-on with, that you're touching, that you're creating with. Your energy transfers to that. So I try to give each piece the benefit of the doubt there.
I think it's beautiful when you know who you're crafting for. Mm-hmm. Because then you can sit and you can think about them and give them everything that they need, so when they receive that piece they're like, oh. You know, they can feel that energy constantly and all the time. It's a wonderful thing. It's a wonderful gift to give to people.
Isn't it though?
It is.
I'm ready to get my hands on that drum when it shows up here,
right?
It may be there tomorrow.
That's what I'm thinking. It'll probably be here tomorrow. I'm super stoked. The last thing I bought was a Chinese violin, two-string violin. I love the sound of it. When I seen it, I was like, man, I really like the sound of it. I mean, two strings, can I go wrong trying to learn it? You know what I mean? It's just two strings. There's only so many notes. So I thought, I'll try this and maybe work myself into something different. I just like exploring and challenging myself. And right now, I've been batting like 0 for 2. I bought a dulcimer. I still haven't really sat down. I still really haven't sat down and learned it yet. I bought an acoustic guitar, which you see right down there. I haven't really fooled with it yet. It's been, drums, I'm all about that. So I'm trying to expand my musical to see if I have any musical talent in other instruments. And so far, I've not been doing good.
But it's so different when you, like, if you were to get a drum from Amazon, that looks just like something Papa would make. You wouldn't have the same energy and quality of work in it. So I think it's always important to support.
We don't know that. I mean, but I, only reason why, you don't know what the energy that person that's doing has put that drum together. And yes, you're gonna have manufactured companies, but there's also smaller companies. And you know who they are when you use Amazon. They're the ones that charge a sales tax. If it's a prime product, you know you're getting a manufactured product.
Mm-hmm.
But what I haven't bought any. I bought one drum my kid busted, which I told you guys about that last week. But I didn't even bother looking on Amazon because I told Papa right before the New Year's, I need to get a drum from you. I want to buy a drum. So I've been owning about it. And then I seen that one he pulled out the other day. And I was like, this is it right here.
There it is. It spoke to you.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the great thing about a musical piece, because you'll get to speak with it and it'll still speak with you, and you'll get to speak together and make songs for a very long time.
Because of percussion, that's my passion. I love percussions.
With that,
I've tried to explore and learn other things, and I'm not having very good success in it.
Even though I sent the drum beater with it, the variation in the hide, it's almost better, in my opinion or personal experience, to play that one as a hand drum. Mm-hmm. Or to use your fingers.
Yeah.
Okay. I can use my fingers.
But you'll have plenty of time to explore it.
I had plenty of practice that as a teenager.
So in the middle of the drum, you're gonna get that nice like boom boom boom, but the farther you go away from the drum, the closer you get to the frame of it, you're gonna get more of that like snare, you know, feeling. So you can go and do And there's really cool.
And there's your little drumming lesson for Luna for the night, for the week.
Yeah.
Drumming with Luna. Next week, she'll be discussing how to properly play the bongos.
The bongos, dropping the beats.
This was a good topic tonight, guys. I hope you guys have watched this tonight here talking with Heathens. Hope you guys enjoyed the topic as well. I think we've learned a little bit about you guys and different techniques. Before we go, before we say goodbye, if there's someone new to the whole idea of meditating, what do you guys suggest folks to go refer to or go check out that help them, help a beginner wanting to get into meditating?
Don't be in a state of resistance. Allow things to come into your mind. Yeah.
And I would say, consider your environment, your atmosphere. And there is no shame in using meditative aids. It doesn't mean you're not doing it. It doesn't mean you're doing it or not doing it right. To try things like incense or nature sounds or classical
experiment with things,
or to just put some noise canceling headphones in to help you block out those street sounds outside of the window or dogs barking. The whole point is for it to work, so help it work to help yourself, and don't worry about what other people are doing and how it works for them. If that works for them, that's great, but it has to work for you or there's no point in doing it.
I know, you just don't even realize you're doing it.
By sitting out there like this doesn't mean it's going to work for you. And that doesn't mean that's the way it has to be. If it doesn't work for you, there's no point. So find the way that it works for you.
Yeah. If you feel you need to move, you don't want to sit still.
You need to scratch an itch. Scratch an itch.
Have fun. Yeah, scratch an itch.
Or you'd be like me and still don't realize you're doing it until you have a show. In the middle of the show, you're like, wait a second.
I hope others have felt this tonight as well, because like you said, you didn't realize you were doing it, but as we talked about it, you know, you found that you are actively
doing a lot.
Meditating.
Well, it's natural to you, so you're not really being mindful of it. It's just part of your routine, like we spoke earlier.
As much as I would want to say that I want to sleep in, I'll even stay up late, midnight, 1 o'clock, and every single morning, I'll be up about 3:30 every single morning. Mm-hmm. My body's all set to
routine. The spirits are wanting to talk to you. They're saying, hey, Sid, I got a message for you.
Get up. We got your coffee ready, your Keurig's ready. All you gotta do is hit the button.
When you get to hear your own ideas. You get to hear your own thoughts.
There's nothing else going on. It's just myself and the universe, and it's just me sitting there waiting for the universe to talk to me. It's just me sitting there in complete silence until she starts talking. Mm-hmm. And then we have a conversation. And then that's when the ideas start popping up. Okay, where do you want to go with this today? What do you want to do with that today? And that's when I get my day starts to begin, is when I just sit and wait. Wait for her to whisper in my ear.
But you wake up knowing that you have purpose.
And I wake up knowing that yes, that's it. That's it. Good point, man. Good point. Good point. Well, anyway, great show again, guys. Thanks for tuning in with us tonight. Be sure to stay right where you're at, because Midgard UC is on next. So be sure to hang out and watch the show. Thanks again for all your support. Thank you for tuning in. Our very first week being on Heathen Nation TV, and I'm excited. A lot of exciting things are coming in the future too, so be sure to keep in touch with us on our Facebook page. You can follow us on Inner Demon Media, or you can catch some of our shows if you're not catching on the premiere. You can find them on YouTube as well. Just punch in Inner Demon Media. It'll take you right all of our past episodes. 200 and some shows you can go back and watch. Full catalog, folks. Beware, though, there's some shenanigans in a lot of them. There's a lot of shenanigans, but you can check them all out there. But be sure, above all, to find us on Facebook, Inner Demon Media. That way you keep in line what's going on, What's the lineups? What's being played on Heathen TV? You'll be able to find it right there on Inner Demon Media. Plus, you will know what times our show's coming on. Keep in touch. Contact. We're always closer than there, whether it's band music-related or show-related. We're always really active there. And so if you got some ideas for a show, that'll be fun, too. Send us a message on the page. Anyway, you guys have a great night. We'll catch you guys next Friday, same time, 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time for another Talking with Heathens. But until then, we're leaving you with some Anoxia with Tears I Bleed. You guys have a great night and catch you next week.